Hi everyone. WebRTC Kite allows you to increase your web sales by on average 52% and leverage your website to bring in more customers, because WebRTC Kite is not a separate web chat app, it's a part of our platform fully integrated with the Wildix communication system. Today, you can automate and streamline your customer service using WebRTC Kite chatbot. This is the very first version of the bot, and it is provided as an SDK, which means it's not a ready product. It requires a web developer to customize its behavior to your specific needs. What I'm showing to you right now is a use case that I wrote and tested myself. Given the fact I'm not a developer at all, probably it will add you some courage in approaching this SDK and give you an idea of what you can actually achieve. To achieve this behavior, I had to make some changes in the JavaScript. I'll show it to you in the end. And right now, let's see how to install the bot and what it can do for you out of the box. First of all, you need to make sure you have WMS version 5.02 or higher. Remember also that, same as a normal user, we need at least a business license for the bot. Create a new dummy user especially for the bot. Currently, you can have only one bot per system, but you can add it to multiple call groups. The bot has the default extension 777999. Add the bot user to the call group that you use for WebRTC Kite. You also need the latest version of the Node.js. You can download it from the internet. Then you need to go to github.com/wildix and download the Kite XMPP bot libraries. Follow our instructions to install all the required dependencies. Now the last thing you need to do is actually run the bot. So make sure you're located in the directory app and run the bot using the command node-index.js. You start to see some information, some logs. This means everything is going in the right direction. Out of the box, during the working hours, the bot will wait for 1 minute to check if there is an available agent, and if not, it will give you the following message. During the non-working hours, it will again wait to make sure there is no agent and give you a different message. This one, we can look it up. These messages are stored in the static TXT files right here in the directory app/responders. Obviously, you will want to customize these files and feel free to do so. How does it check the working hours? Well, it's not done through the WMS timetables. You can see it right here in the responder JavaScript file. Right here, you can edit them if you need to. Now let's see how to modify the bot to do what I described in the beginning. You can actually copy the code right from the document. The code was reviewed by our R&D teams. But I'll explain which changes I made and why. In the responder.js file, there are public methods. Hello. If this method returns a string, it is used as a welcome message for the user from the bot. And this was the welcome message of the bot. It can extract and use the name that I provided during authorization. So it feels more human, like it knows my name. Nice. In the hello method, I didn't need to modify anything. I just went to modify the content of one of those static files. In particular, I modified the content of the working hours file and made sure that the bot provides clear instructions in the first message, like type events or type address. However, I had to work on the same method, because this is the response of the bot in case something was entered by the user. And here I used a simple if, else, if, and else. So if the message received was address, give me the content of this file. If the message was events, give me the content of another file. Else returns, sorry, I didn't understand you. That's all for today. If you have some JavaScript knowledge and if you like to work on such stuff, then for sure you will be able to create an intelligent chatbot in no time. But if you don't have such skills and time for it, then you can pass it to a web developer and explain your use cases and scenarios in which you would like to use the bot. So thanks for watching and good luck with it!